Oh. The Triforce is the harmonious union of power, wisdom, and courage. It has been the object of countless battles between the forces of light and darkness. Each time the Triforce fell into the clutches of evil, Hyrule was plunged into misery. But in every age, a hero, clad in green, would restore peace to the land. During one of these dark times, the legendary hero split the spirit of evil into four fragments, sealing each away to finally break the cycle of destruction. Three of the fragments were scattered across time and space. The final fragment was sealed in a sacred temple built upon holy ground, imprisoned by the blade of evil's bane. After an arduous battle, Link and his comrades slew King Dodongo, but the beast was only ever intended as a distraction. The army of monsters had taken Hyrule Castle. Worse, after the dust had settled, Princess Zelda was nowhere to be found. Impa and Link searched the battlefield for any sign of her, but to no avail. Although the battle had been lost, Impa foresaw Link's importance to the coming war. She bestowed upon him a green tunic, the sign of the legendary hero. Link did not believe himself worthy of the honor, but he was determined to help Impa and her remaining soldiers locate Zelda. Weeks passed. Impa heard a rumor that a handful of soldiers were holding out against the monsters in Farron Woods. The leader of this resistance was supposedly a young woman. Impa dared to hope that this unknown woman was Zelda. Link and Impa decided to make their way to the forest by way of the Elden Caves, a path with its own dangers. Link and his allies were saved from the dangers of the Elden Caves by a mysterious youth named Sheik. Joined by their new ally, Impa's troops exited the caves and emerged in Farron Woods. There, they found a hidden village overrun with monsters. While Link and Impa wanted to continue their search for Zelda, they could not ignore the plight of the villagers. Without hesitation, they sprang into battle.
Oh.
For generations, Hyruleans have told the tale of the war across the ages. This is how it begins. Deep in the forests, far from mortal eyes, a great sorceress watched over the balance of the Triforce. Through her magic, she could see across ages, able to read the fates of all who lived, but never interfering. That is, until a unique soul caught her attention. The soul of the hero of legend, eternally reborn when Hyrule's need is greatest. Through her powers, the sorceress should have seen that the hero was bound to another. Instead, she saw only a soul that was unlike any she had known. And while the sorceress was preoccupied, a fragment of darkness, locked in its prison, saw an opportunity. The whispering darkness wormed its way into her heart. It pushed the light away and warped her curiosity into a desperate desire to possess the legendary hero's soul. Of course, this evil had its own desires. To use the Triforce to resurrect itself and conquer Hyrule once again. Having pushed the light from her heart, the darkness compelled her to open the Gate of Souls, the doorway of time itself. Monsters from across the ages pour through the gate, bringing ruin to the land of Hyrule once more. The leader of the resistance in Farron Woods was a young sorceress named Lana. She was of the same clan as Sia, who had summoned the monsters to Hyrule. Lana had been fighting Sia's army since it arrived. Sia now sought to complete the Triforce and use it to conquer Hyrule. Link and Impa decided to join forces with Lana to prevent further tragedy. Although the monsters of Farron Woods had been defeated, Sia still controlled most of Hyrule. Every day, more creatures appeared and swarmed the land. Link and Impa fought on against the darkness, sorely missing Zelda's leadership. Only one solution remained: stem the tide of monsters by closing the Gate of Souls. The heroes headed to the Valley of Seers to put an end to the bloodshed.
Oh.
Sia had already claimed the Triforce of Power. From Link, she stole the Triforce of Courage. The Triforce of Wisdom was the birthright of the royal family of Hyrule. Yet she bore it when Sia attacked. Once Sia possessed all the pieces of the Triforce, she used its incredible power to bend time and space and open doorways through the ages. Portals to three eras appeared. Lana explained to the others that a gate of souls had been opened in each of these eras, and it was through these gates that the monsters came. By opening these gates, Sia had released the fragment of evil spirit imprisoned in each of the other eras. The task before the heroes was therefore to travel through each portal and close its gate. Once all the gates were closed, they could begin repairing the damage Sia had inflicted on their land. With time growing short, Link and his allies split up to handle all three gates simultaneously. They each vowed to close their gate and return safely. Leading a small force of Hyrulean soldiers, Impa stepped into one of the newly opened portals. The kingdom spread out before her seemed like the Hyrule she knew, yet it was somehow very different. Before long, she realized that they had traveled back to the era of the mythical hero of time. Awed, Impa began her search for the Gate of Souls. She sensed an evil presence on Death Mountain and set out for the ominous peak. And with her came the mysterious Sheik.
Oi.
At his request, Impa had fought her way to the summit of Death Mountain to rescue Princess Rudo. There, she subdued the Goron chieftain, Darunia, who had temporarily lost his senses. Upon freeing Princess Rudo, however, Impa was shocked to learn the reason for the conflict between the Zora and Goron people. The ancient water temple was teeming with monsters that poured from the Gate of Souls. What's more, the monsters were apparently led by Princess Zelda herself. Hoping to make sense of this disturbing revelation, Impa and her newfound allies journeyed to Lake Hylia. When they arrived, they were greeted by a Zelda seemingly consumed by evil.
Huh?
Lana stepped through her portal and found a jarring sight. Wherever she looked, the kingdom was consumed by shadow. Though she knew of the Twilight Realm, she had never seen it firsthand. Lana's sorcery could not reveal who or what was causing the twilight to cover Hyrule so completely. She soon came upon a small village beset by monsters. Her mission to close the Gate of Souls would have to wait.
Oh!
Lana had saved an unusual girl named Agatha from the Twilight. To thank Lana for her rescue, Agatha gave her a goddess butterfly, an insect that could guide her wherever she wished to go. A curious Twily named Midna also joined the party for reasons of her own. The heroes follow the goddess butterfly, eventually arriving at the Palace of Twilight. There, they met a terrible foe. It was Zand, the usurper king of the Twilight Realm. Lana and Midna would have to overcome his unnatural powers to complete their task.
Thank you.
Link and his troops step through one of the portals, appearing in an era of fantastical sights. He had heard tell of a land in the clouds, but now he could see Skyloft with his own eyes, though he was not the first new arrival. Overrun with monsters, the floating island faced imminent destruction. Though vastly outnumbered, Link did not hesitate. He and his allies leapt into the fray to save Skyloft from disaster. a servant of the goddess Hylia, joined Link, and together they drove away the Dragon Knight Volga. But despite the victory, Girahim managed to slip away in the chaos. Hoping to destroy Girahim and close the Gate of Souls, Link followed Fi's advice and hurried to the sealed grounds. The Hyrulean army advanced quickly in order to catch up to their quarry. And that was when Girahim sprang his trap.
Yeah.
With the Gate of Souls closed in each era, Link and his allies were reunited. Sheik was at last revealed as Zelda, relieving much worry about her fate. Meanwhile, Ganondorf had recovered three of his four spirit fragments. He chose to leave Sia's body, her usefulness at an end. Free of Ganondorf's control but tragically corrupted, Sia resolved to make Link and the Triforce hers and hers alone. Using powerful rituals to strengthen her forces, she redoubled her attacks on Hyrule. But all was not lost. Zelda directed her forces to the Temple of the Sacred Sword in search of the one thing that could save them all. Link took up the Master Sword and proved himself the hero of legend. Armed as he was with the Blade of Evil's Bane, Link easily dispatched the newly revived Wizro. The evil magician's parting words in their ears, Link and his allies set out to confront Sia at the Temple of Souls. With a string of victories behind them, the Hyrulean army's morale had improved remarkably. Even Link began to feel that he was invincible while the Master Sword was in his hands. Soon, he was allowing overconfidence to cloud his judgment, rushing headlong into hordes of enemies. Sia had been waiting for Link to overextend himself, giving her a chance to strike. And as the two sides battled, unknown eyes watched from the shadows.
Thank you.
Link's rashness nearly cost him his life as shadowy doubles overwhelmed him. At the last moment, Link's allies salvaged a rescue from otherwise certain defeat. The Master Sword is a mighty weapon, but its true power can be used only by someone who understands the bonds of friendship. The Hyrulean army was rallying its strength, but Sia's forces still controlled much of their homeland. The only way to save Hyrule was to defeat Sia. The Hyrulean army headed to the Valley of Seers to force a decisive battle. But Sia did not sit idle, despite her overwhelming advantage. She found new ways to fortify her troops using her own life force. The cost to herself was irrelevant, so long as she crushed her enemies. The final battle between the armies of light and darkness was about to unfold.
Ah!
Link and his friends defeated Sia and her legions, returning peace to Hyrule. But that peace would be short-lived. At the moment when Link drew the Master Sword from its pedestal, he had inadvertently broken the seal on the last Spirit Fragment's prison, setting it free to unite with the others. His spirit made whole, Ganondorf was reborn. His first act was to return to Gerudo Desert, the center of his power in Hyrule. Once there, he summoned the spirits of Zant and Ghirahim from their imprisonment to serve him. Finally, Ganondorf would hold the complete Triforce in his hands and wield its full power. Knowing his enemies were approaching, he built a stronghold in Gerudo Desert for the coming battles. With Zant and Ghirahim at his side, Ganondorf was poised to conquer Hyrule. The future was bleak for the forces of light.
Oh!
With terrifying speed, the reborn Ganondorf raised his army and fortified his position in Gerudo Desert. More powerful than ever, he moved to take the scattered pieces of the Triforce. His first target was the Triforce of Power, still in Lana's possession. Ganondorf had wielded it long ago and claimed it as his right. Regaining it would give him the might to seize the other two pieces. With this thought, Ganondorf led a massive army to the Valley of Seers. Knowing she could never defeat him, Lana fled the valley even as the Hyrulean army rushed to her aid. But Ganondorf outmaneuvered her and cut off her retreat, attacking fiercely to retake the Triforce of Power.
Thank you.
Ganondorf's forces had defeated the Hyrulean army and wrenched the Triforce of Power from Lana's grasp. Yet the other two pieces remained with Link and Zelda in Hyrule Castle. If Ganondorf could take the castle and complete the Triforce, Hyrule would be at his mercy. He readied his army for a siege. Meanwhile, Zelda's forces stood ready to defend their home at all costs. Link stood at the head of the army, the shining Triforce of Courage inspiring his troops. This battle would decide Hyrule's fate. Would the light endure? Or would darkness spread to every corner of the land? The next moments would decide. Assembled all three pieces of the Triforce. With its unlimited might, he summoned ever greater hordes of monsters. Seeing that the battle was won, Ganondorf vanished from sight. When Zelda learned of the Demon King's disappearance, she saw a thin ray of hope. If the remaining Hyrulean army could defeat Zant and Ghirahim in their master's absence, perhaps there was a chance. Taking the fight to the enemy's stronghold in Gerudo Desert, Zelda was determined to end the war before the day was through. Triumph in Gerudo Desert. Impa's forces managed to pinpoint Ganondorf's location. He had conquered Hyrule Castle and transformed it in his own image. From this fortress, he prepared for an unspeakable ritual. Link, Zelda, and all of their allies from across the ages marched toward Ganon's tower, ready for the final, decisive battle. If they fell, all of Hyrule would fall with them.
Ha! Mm-hmm.